And tonight I'm going to show you my latest recipe for raw chocolate. I've got a couple of films up on YouTube already about raw chocolate making, and over the years I've been doing this, I've refined the recipe down to what I'm going to share with you tonight. So the methods are going to be the same as before. I'm going to go through all that with you, and then the difference is going to be that this is my latest recipe, which I think is the most tasty and delicious. So off we go. So I've got all the things I need. I've got the scales. I've got what we call a bain-marie, which is a pan with hot water in. And on top of it, I've got an empty pan, which fits very nicely into the pan underneath. The water's boiling, so I've just turned the heat down, and that is just ready for me to take action. So the next thing I need to do is to start adding all the ingredients to the pan. And off we go. So my first ingredient is going to be the coconut oil. And for this recipe, I'm going to use 200 grams. This is the largest amount of anything that goes in. It does help if you have the coconut oil in a warm room. It's much easier to get out of the tub that way. So there we are, there's 200 grams of the coconut oil. That's going to go in first, and that will just start to melt. So to that I'm going to add 100 grams of cacao butter. And this is very different, this comes in lumps which look like that. So, right, so 100 grams of cacao butter. So while that's melting, I'm going to change containers. And when you do this, you need to tear the device to get it to go back to zero again. And now I can continue. So I've got 200 grams of coconut oil, 100 grams of cacao butter. So now I'm going to have 50 grams of cacao powder. So I'll just put that to one side, because I'm going to wait until all this has melted before I add anything else to it. That'll take a few more minutes. And in the meantime, my next thing is going to be the cacao paste. And I'm going to want 50 grams of this as well. And I'm going to measure that back in this container, so I'll need to tear it again. Now the difference with the cacao paste is it's actually little lumps, so I'm going to have to cut those up over here on the cutting board. You don't have to cut them into terribly small pieces, but at least you want to break it up so they're reasonably small. Leave that there so it's all ready to go in. The next thing I can do is put yet another container on the scales, and now I'm going to measure out 100 grams of raw honey. And then on top of that, I'm going to put three teaspoons of vanilla essence. And this is a new ingredient. I haven't used vanilla essence before, but I use it now because it's got such a good flavour. And I've got 1 teaspoon in there. I'm going to have to wait till that's now full. I'll put the other couple of teaspoons in afterwards. So in the meantime, I'm just waiting for the last lumps to melt. So we now have the cacao butter and the coconut oil have all melted in the pan. It gives you that particular colour, which means I'm ready to start to add all the ingredients one by one. And the first thing that's going to go in is the powder. and all I do is I literally just sprinkle in the powder whilst I'm stirring. And that actually goes in pretty fast. Now the other thing you've got to be careful of at this point is not to let it get too hot. So I'm going to take it off the heat and put it here for a moment just to let it cool down a bit. Because you don't want, as soon as you start to add the dark ingredients, you want to make sure it doesn't overheat. So I'm now going to carry on. The next thing is going to be the cacao paste, which has been sitting on the board here. So that's going to go in next. And then I will stir that one in. And now I'm ready for the next ingredient. And cinnamon is really lovely because it combines very well with the cacao taste, but also it's very warming. It's a nice warming spice. I've added the cinnamon. So now all the dry ingredients are in. I'm going to put it back on the heat, let it warm up again because I've just cooled it down by putting all those ingredients in. And the next thing is going to be the honey and the first teaspoon of the vanilla extract. And I usually let most of it roll out of the tub until finally I get to the point that I need to get the spoon in to get the last of it out. Which means all I have to add now is the remaining 2 teaspoons of the vanilla extract. So that's the whole thing prepared. Everything's in there that we need. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the scales away and bring out the blender, which makes such a difference. You can make the chocolate without a blender, in which case you stir it very, very thoroughly and pour it into the moulds with stirring. But because I've got the blender, what I can do is I can pour the whole thing into here. If you've got one of those spatulas with a silicone edge on it, it's really good to get all the last bits out. Then as quickly as possible I blend, only for a short time on a low setting. I'll give it a bit more. And that's it. So all I have left to do now is to pour the liquid into the moulds, and I'll literally pour it until it's nearly covered the bottom of the mould, and allow itself to carry on spreading until the mould is completely covered in the chocolate. And these moulds are actually from Cauldron Foods Lincolnshire Sausages. They make an excellent mould. It's a vegetarian sausage packet, and I've got a little bit left. There we go. And now every single mould is nicely covered on the bottom. And the only thing I have left to do is to put them into the fridge, preferably in the freezing compartment. For if it's a freezing compartment, 20 minutes is fine, more like 45 minutes if it's in the fridge. And that's it. That's the job done. So we finish making our raw chocolate.